Hi folks, it's Bob from Mountain Credit Farm. Today we've got a video for vehicle maintenance and repair playlist. And today, we're going to replace the water pump on my wife's 2003 Ford Taurus. Today we're going to replace a water pump, and while we're at it, we're going to replace motor mount on my wife's Ford Taurus. This is a 2003 Ford Taurus with a 3.0 overhead valve engine. There are two engines for this. Both of them are 3.0. One is overhead valve, one's dual overhead cam. Make sure you tell people overhead valve. But this is an engine mount. You can see right there, I don't know if you can see it, but that one is worn out. So we're gonna replace this and the water pump. Before you get started, a couple of things, safety-wise. These struts aren't worth a damn. They'll come down and put a hood on your head and a hurting on your head in a hurry. Plus, we're gonna take that one off to get it out of the way. So, first thing to do is disconnect the battery. I'm going to take the vice grips that's keeping the hood off my head and use them to disconnect the battery. Next thing to get out of the way, your reservoir. By taking those two hoses loose, this bolt, which is 10 millimeter. Now I'm back. I may leave again here in a minute, because if this hose gives me much more trouble, I'm going to turn the camera off so that y'all don't hear some bad language. This is a family channel.
Okay, I got the tank out. I skipped a little bit. I did one thing and didn't tell y'all, and that is your next order of business before you do anything else is don't take them out, but these four half-inch bolts right here that hold the pulley on for your water pump, loosen them. Don't take them out yet. Just loosen them. Okay? Then, start working on getting some stuff out of the way. Actually, I skipped a step. Right down there. That's got to be loosened. I don't remember what size that is. 15 does get it. You know, every once in a while you have a epiphany. I just have one. I keep my tools in a mess. Until they get so messed up I can't work. Notice using a breaker bar for this. I should be using a ratchet. That would be epiphany. I can't find a half inch drive ratchet. I think sometime shortly after I finish changing this water pump on this car, I think I'm probably going to straighten out my tools. At least I'm not going to have any brains. Well, folks, it's Bob again, and we are back for day two. I'm sticking on the same video, but we are back for day two. I had to quit yesterday. I was getting hot. My back was killing me. Doesn't matter, personal information. I'm 62 years old. I've had four heart attacks, and I've got emphysema and diabetes, and I just don't have a lot of endurance anymore. I can do everything I used to, but I can't do it for as long. I can't do it fast. So, anyway, before you'll notice there's a few things I've done since we were here last. What I want to do is go through a list of exactly the steps you take to do this, to change a water pump. And you'll see where we left off, and I'll point out some of the things I've done since we were here. First thing to do, safety-wise, always disconnect the battery. No, you're working on the water system, you're not working on the electrical system, but you do have to move the alternator up. There are hot wires on the back of the alternator. Disconnect the battery. For convenience, I've taken the hood strut off over here on this side, on the passenger side. I used a pair of mice grips over there on the other side to keep the hood from falling. If the hood strut doesn't have to come off, but it gets it out of your way. Obviously, drain your cooling system, which I do. All I have is water in it. I'm on grass, and I drain the water on the grass. Next, remove the coolant cover down right here. At that point, reach down and you loosen these four bolts that are on the water pump. Don't take it off right then. You just break them loose, because as long as there's tension on the serpentine belt, it'll keep them turning. If you try to loosen them once you've got the serpentine belt off, unless your water pump's totally locked up, you'll have to play ahead and get them loose. Remove the serpentine belt, which you take and put a wrench right here on the tensioner, and you pry it this way, which makes the tensioner go that way, which takes the tension off the serpentine belt, and you take it off. The easiest way is to pull it off the alternator, and it'll fall off the rest of it. Dog bone. Here's a new one. Replacing the old one. This is the rear engine mount. It goes, but it goes from back in here to right here. Get it out. I've already got the old one out of the way. That's what's holding the camera down so it doesn't fall over. Take the alternator loose. Two bolts. Here. Take the bolts out. Set this over the side. You don't have to disconnect anything. Then there's a bracket that the motor mount goes to right here. You take it loose, take it off. All this I did yesterday, all the video I believe. Idler pulley. I didn't do this yesterday. I went past this. I did take the idler pulley off right here. Next is remove the belt tensioner. That's what I didn't do yesterday yet. I skipped past it, did some other things. I'm about to go back and do it because I can't go any farther. Remove the belt tensioner. Once I've got to take this off to get to my last water pump bolt. So it's 12 bolts to hold the water pump on. I took 10 of them off yesterday after the camera was off. You remove the belt tensioner. And there's an air conditioning support bracket. You really can't see it from here. It's back down in there. But once this is out of the way, you'll be able to see it. And you take that off. Remove the heater hose, which I've already done. Disconnect the camshaft and the crankshaft position sensor. That is this wire right here, which connects way down here. It's a simple push on the button and it'll unplug. Get it out. At that point, you remove the pump pulley right here. Take those four out, pull the pulley out of the way. And then you remove the pump. Like I said, it's 12 bolts. 10 of them are out already. So let's just keep going here. Let's go back and get two things that I haven't done. I didn't do this yesterday. Number one, like I said, I was totally out of energy. That's not gonna work. I was totally out of energy. Back was killing me. And I didn't have one of these. I had to borrow one from a friend of mine. So now I do. Now, I have seen some people say that you can use a 1/4 inch Allen wrench. It'll go in here tight enough to do it. Well, I've got a set of Allen wrenches. The 1/4 inch will go in there pretty tight. It doesn't go in there good enough. And for me, it would have stripped out the head bolt, and then there would have been a problem. So it's good to use the right tool. Okay, after you get the belt tensioner out of the way, right here, then you have the air conditioning support bracket, which is this black piece right here. I've already taken that. This is also one of the studs for the water pump, so I have to get the bracket out of the way, and the other end is down here. 13 millimeter, and I don't know what the SAE equivalent is. Now we have the last two bolts exposed. Okay, the good news is I found a 13 millimeter deep well. Bad news is, quarter-inch drive, and I like never got that roof loose. Didn't turn the camera on until I had it loose, so y'all didn't get to hear all the nasty things I said. Anyway, this is bolt number 12. There are two bolts like this that have a bolt and then a mounting bolt, and what mounts back there, I don't remember. We'll see when we put it back together. Nobody lied to me. That should be it. Now, don't worry. I generally don't subscribe to the get a bigger hammer method for making things work. And that's not what I'm doing here. It just happened to be the hammer that was handy. And we're going to try just a little bit of shock therapy. Not hit anything hard, just a little bit, try to break the rope loose. Like that. Folks, y'all aren't really missing anything. Yeah, I've had the camera off for a while. But so far, all you've been missing is me cussing from knuckle busting, trying to get all this crap off. Get everything off. All the old gaskets. Or you will have a leak. You'll be cussing because you'll have to take it all back down again. Be careful when you're scraping it off, though. That is an aluminum housing. Aluminum scratches easy, it scratches deep. A scratch will leak just as bad as if you don't get the gasket. I wanted to take a minute while I rest my back from leaning over and point something out to you. This is the old pump. fuel pump that I just took off. And when I first took it off and looked at it, I said, oh crap, that's not good. My pump wasn't a problem. So I was losing water. Cooling efficiency was okay. But I was having to add a gallon of water every morning before this car went anywhere. And I took it off. I looked. I don't see any evidence of water having leaked and corroded around the edges. Nothing around the shaft. The impeller looks like it's in pretty good shape. Maybe this wasn't my problem. But then I turned, grabbed hold of it, and turned. That was really rough. You can feel something just isn't right there. This is supposed to turn nice and smooth, but it doesn't. So, I guess I need a new water. And I am 99% sure that this was the problem. Even if it wasn't the problem, it needed replacing, and I'll have to go buy it. But this just turns really rough, especially when I take the new one and turn it to compare. That's like glass. That is just so, so smooth. Okay, I'm back. All of you missed in that 30 minutes, 20 minutes, whatever. Was me doing some fussing and cussing. And so what I was doing was cleaning off the old gasket material around where the water pump was. Tell you something. It's frustrating. It's hard to get to with a scraper on the right angle to get it. But get it. Because if you don't, all this work is going to be for nothing. You're going to take it all back apart, scrape all that gasket material off anyway, go to the auto parts store, get another gasket, and reinstall the water pump because you'll have leaks if you don't. Okay. We have the surface where the new water pump bolts up on the car, cleaned up, and it's time to install a new water pump. First thing we're going to do is take, because you can't put a gasket on and expect it to stay while you turn this vertical to install it. You want this, all this shiny surface, but don't get it anywhere in there or here. All this, they wear Loctite, blue Loctite, do not use red Loctite. Remind you again, blue Loctite, not red. Right here, quit, even though that's shiny, and the same over here. There. Carefully, so it's in the right spot. Put your new gasket on. place, no wrinkles, lined up with the hole. That's the one thing I did. I told you to cover the hole real good. That's right. Don't block up the holes. That's wrong. Now, let's go start installing a water pump. Okay, I'm going to put the water pump back on. I'm going to tell y'all now, I'm going to try to film all of this and then I'll edit out the little things that are just wasting time. But, I may not be able to. My battery may die. I don't have a ton of that. Now, be careful when you're doing this. You've got a ton of places where you can bump the gasket, get it out of line, get it where it doesn't belong. You need to get everything just like it needs to be. Put it in place. I like starting with these small bolts. And don't really tighten. Get them down snug. Holding the, all you want to do is get it tight enough to where it is holding the water pump in place. Basically what I just did with my finger tight was plus maybe that much. It's aluminum, it will warp. Don't tighten it down. Little by little working your way around. All by feel. Hey, Damon. You know what? That one down there is not as bad as it was coming off. You know why? This idler pulley was still here when I took that off. The way I'd been told to do this was to do that first. Then do the idler pulley. I mean, do the idler pulley first and then pull the pump. Boy, that would be so bad. Thank you. seven big ones. Don't laugh, you'll be old farts too one day. Okay, water pump is back on. Now, how does all this stuff go back together? This will be down the bottom. But when you're taking all this apart, you do it this way. You disconnect the battery. You disconnect the hood strut. Empty the water and antifreeze out of it. Remove the coolant recovery tank. Loosen but do not remove the water pump pulley bolts. Remove the dog bone, which runs from here. That's the dog bone is the rear motor mount. Get the serpentine belt out of the way. Remove the alternator. Pull the alternator out of here and set it aside. Remove the motor mount bracket. That's what attaches right there. Remove the idler pulley. Here. The idler pulley goes on here. The belt tensioner goes on here. Remove the AC support bracket. That's that little black bracket that was down here. See what I'm going to put back on. Remove the heater hose right here. Disconnect the crankshaft position sensor, which is the wire I just showed you. Remove the pump. Pulley bolts, the pulley from here, and take the pump off, 12 bolts. And you just do all that in reverse order. All that will be in the order of taking it apart will be in the description below.